Hey friends, welcome back to a new video. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you're new here, I'm Sylvia from Catchy Cravings, and I'd love to inspire you and help you master healthy eating, but also healthy living. And I do lots of minimalism, self-help, and healthy recipes kind of thing. So if you're interested, then be sure to check out my channel down below. So today I'm going to do a Q&A, and I asked you guys on Instagram and also here on YouTube on the communities tab of my channel what kind of questions you have for me. And to be honest, at first I was really scared whether I would get any questions at all, but you guys asked so many questions and that made me so happy. So thank you so much to all of you that asked me questions. So I'm just gonna jump right on in and try to answer every single one of your questions. Also, I wanted to quickly say I'm going to keep your usernames anonymous here just for privacy's sake. I don't know if you guys want me saying them here on the internet, so I'm not going to show that. So question number one is, where do I get my recipes from? Now, there are a bunch of different places where I get my recipe from. Either I saw some type of picture that looked really delicious on Instagram and I thought, well, I really want to try to recreate that. Sometimes it's recipes that I find through Instagram, through other channels that I follow on Instagram, but also Pinterest is a huge platform where I find recipes. Also YouTube, other YouTubers, or by searching for specific ingredients. Sometimes I have 2 to 3 ingredients left in my fridge and I'll search for example, asparagus recipes or roasted asparagus, and then through a Google search, I will stumble upon recipes. And the recipes that I personally have on my blog are usually either ones that I've created absolutely from scratch just by being creative in the kitchen, or sometimes it will be an inspiration from a different recipe that I've seen. So maybe I saw a recipe that I thought looked really great, but I would change things here and there, and then I end up changing so much that it ends up being a new recipe. So that will then go up on my blog. Then question number two is, what do I normally eat for dinner? And this is really different because I'm someone that likes variety, especially when it comes to food. I cannot eat the same thing over and over again. So dinner will be very different every single day. The approach I have is I start with the carb and think of what kind of carb do I want. I'll think, do I want rice or do I want pasta? And then from the rice, I will see what kind of things go with the rice. Most often it's some type of curry, just because that is something that can be really easily done plant-based and vegan. Or I'll have pasta. Sometimes I'll even have sweet potato as a carb. Sometimes I'll have a ratatouille with a bread that I can eat with it, but mostly it's rice. And if it's rice, then curry or pasta. But it's really very, very different. But if you want to know what I eat every single day, I most often post it on my Instagram story, so you can follow me on Instagram. Then the next question is favorite YouTubers. I'm someone that, to be honest, watches quite a lot of YouTube. I really love YouTube, which is why I also went ahead and created my own channel. What I look for in a YouTube channel is that I want it to inspire me in some way or let me want to be a better person after the video. And that is something that I really strive for in my videos as well, that you guys are inspired and motivated to be a better version of yourself. But right now I really love Wa and Weili's channel. I'm not sure what the channel is called, Wally TV, I think. They're this really cute, amazing, inspiring couple that live in LA, and they're both Asian, and the things that they do are just really Asian, and that makes me feel very wholesome because I live in Germany and it's not super Asian here. And yeah, it just kind of reminds me of home. And also just the things that they do really inspire me sustainability wise, but also just to be out in nature. Another channel I really love is Jen Im's channel. Her video editing style really inspires me, and also the whole aesthetic of her videos. Also she is very inspiring when it comes to entrepreneurship and being her own boss and having her own company. And then last but not least, another channel I really love and I've been watching for, or I've been loving for so long, is that of Claudia Salewski. With her, it's also the editing style that I absolutely love. Her videos are edited with so much creativity and passion. Her editing style is really something that I look up to and strive towards. Then someone asks, which video of yours are you most proud of / was the most fun to make? Well, this was a really difficult question I had to think about. The one I'm most proud of, I think, is my thankfulness video, because I had so much fun editing wise. I'm not sure if you guys noticed, but I recorded quite a few sound effects extra and then cut it into the video so that the sound effects highlighted the visuals better. And I just had a lot of fun playing around with sound effects and the visuals and then doing the voiceover. And I think it turned out really cool. And I put so much time into it. I'm really happy with the results. And what was the most fun to make? That one was pretty fun with the sound effects, but just my travel videos are pretty fun to make, but also because there's just that sentiment attached to it. It reminds me of the trip that we went on. I think the Berlin video I really like as well, even though I'm using my old camera in that video and everything is quite shaky. But if you ignore the shakiness, I really like that video as well, the way the clips are cut together. I feel like those videos I can be more creative and I really enjoy that. As to kind of a sit down video like this, it doesn't give me too much space for being creative, but those creative videos also just take so much longer. So I don't think I would be able to only do those really awesomely creative videos. I do have to kind of balance it out with a few sit down videos that are hopefully also really valuable to you guys. Then the next question is, how old am I? I am 23. I'm curious to know if you guys thought I was older or younger. I've gotten both before. Then the most asked question on my whole channel is, what ethnicity am I? I've gotten a lot of people saying that they think that I'm from the Philippines. So I'm from Germany and I currently live in Germany, and my ethnicity is I am half German, half Taiwanese. Also, another question is, why am I in Germany and whether I'm an international student here? So no, I'm not an international student. I am from Germany, so I'm kind of local here. And what I'm doing here is I study. I am in university. Then tying onto that, someone else asked what I do for a living. So I am currently a student. I have studied media and communications, and I've got my bachelor degrees in that, and that is already done. But I'm currently taking additional economy marketing courses. Soon I will have to look for a job, look for some type of internship, because YouTube isn't 100% paying my bills yet, but hopefully that will be the case someday. And that ties into the next question, is how do I get paid on YouTube? So contrary to common belief, I do not get paid on the amount of subscribers I have, and I also do not get paid on the amount of views that I have. The way that YouTube pays me is that every time someone watches an advertisement that comes before or during or after my videos, I get paid if they watch it or click on it. And it is a very complicated kind of calculation and an algorithm, but there is no set amount for each advertisement that is watched. There is something called a CPM that every YouTuber has that is very individual to them. And the CPM is the cost per mil, which means the amount that I get paid per 1,000 people that watched the ad. So it's not 1,000 people that watched the video, but 1,000 people that watched the ad, the advertisement, or clicked on the advertisement. And that CPM ranges from, some YouTubers have $2 and some YouTubers have extremely high CPMs like $14, but it's usually between $2 to, I think, $4. So for every 1,000 people that click on the ad, I get about $2. It fluctuates a lot. So I don't get too much, but if you guys want to help me out and have the time, then you guys can watch a ad that comes in my video, or you can click on an ad if you want, but no pressure here, just if you guys feel like helping me out. Then someone else asked, what is my favorite food? Now this for me was probably one of the most difficult questions to answer because I have no idea. I love food, but there's just so much amazing food that it's so hard to choose, and it really depends on my mood. But right now, if I had to choose, I think I'd have to say a bagel with cream cheese and tomatoes and smoked salmon. Then a similar question is, if I could only eat one thing for the rest of my life, what would I eat? Now, I would not eat salmon on bagel because I think the salmon is just too strong of a taste. I would get sick of that really quickly. It has to be something that tastes quite neutral, but it's also has lots of variety in it, because as I said, I really need and want that variety. So this question is also really hard to answer. I don't think it could be pasta. I'm sick of pasta really quickly. I also don't think it could be pizza or just something that's too heavy with too much cheese. I don't think it could be curry, because if I eat the same type of curry every single day, I think I will get sick of that pretty quickly as well. Then if I think of Chinese food, there are lots of things that are absolutely delicious, but I don't think I could eat every single day for the rest of my life. For example, when we were traveling in Taiwan, my boyfriend and I, there was this baozi stand that was so amazing. It was so cheap and it was so good that we ate there 3 times in a row, and the owner knew us. But by the third day, we were so sick of it. We felt so nauseous because it was just so, the flavors were so intense. It was good, but the third day it was just too much. So I think it has to be something that is light flavor wise but also has variety. So that's how I then came to think of a salad. I know this sounds really simple, but because I feel like a salad has a lots of different components and it's nice and fresh, but I think it has to be a salad that needs to have lots of different things, that has flavors. I once waited tables at an Italian restaurant for a while as a job, and I was allowed a meal after my shift, and I would always have a salad with some bread as a side, and the salad I think had pepperoni and goat cheese, I think, or feta cheese, olives, and I'm not sure what else there was on, but I had that pretty much every single time. So I feel like a salad is something I could have every single day. Then the next question is, have you ever made vegan kimchi? If yes, can you share a recipe? So I have never made vegan kimchi, but it is actually something that I really want to do. It is on my to-do list for the near future. My mom makes the best kimchi ever, but I don't think it's vegan. I'll have to ask her. I really do want to try to make my own kimchi. And if I succeed, I'll of course share the recipe with you guys. Then someone asked whether I am vegan. So I am currently not vegan, but I eat plant-based, or I eat vegan about 90% of the time. Sometimes I will have meat, but that is really very seldomly, maybe once a month, maybe even less. But the meat is then always organic and grass-fed, and I just make sure that comes from a good source that I can trust. Because I'm not plant-based 100% of the time, I don't call myself vegan. Or actually have a video where my boyfriend and I talk about eating plant-based, and in that video I said that I kind of forgot how I came to being vegan. We had watched the movie, I think, What the Health. I'm not 100% a fan of that movie, just because I feel like they say a few things that I felt like were a little over dramatic. So I went onto their website and they actually list out all these studies that they quote and all the sources that they use for their information, and went on these studies and looked at these studies, and I actually found out that a few things they had kind of exaggerated or put out of context. So I didn't 100% agree with the things that they said, but I saw for myself that there was some truth to the things that they said, and that being vegan is very beneficial, not only environmentally but also health-wise. And then I decided to be 100% vegan, but that didn't really work out very well. I could see some minor health struggles. I'm not sure if it is connected to being vegan, but I guess that it is. So then I switched to being vegan most of the time, and then sometimes I will have meat or so, or sometimes also egg, but I very rarely have dairy. Then someone asked, how do you edit your videos? So this process is actually really different depending on the type of video. First, of course, I'll import all my footage. Then, depending on whether I am filming with a mic directly connected to the camera or not, I will have to sync up the microphone recorded voice of mine. And then I will have to color grade my footage, make sure that all the colors and the white balance and the lighting is right. Then I will have to cut out any ums and ahs. And then depending on if I want a title blended in, I'll add some titles. And whether I want music, I'm going to add some music to the background. Depending on what I'm talking about, if I want to blend in some type of B-roll or other footage, I will lay that on top. Also, I will add some type of sound effects depending on whether I want to have it here or there. Sometimes if I want to add some type of picture or some type of icon, I need to go ahead and create that icon on Canva. And then I take that image, put that into GIMP, which is kind of like Photoshop, and then cut out the edge, and then I go back to the video editor and then add it into the video editor. So it is kind of a complicated process, but I think this process would be made so much easier if my editing tools were better. I don't really have a set method or recipe that I go by editing my videos. It really depends, but it does take me quite some time. I would say a video takes me on average 6 to 8 hours to edit a video. I'm not sure, but it really depends on the video as well, as I said. Then someone asks, what do you do to keep the weight off after eating? Weight can be a very sensitive topic. I am someone that is blessed with good genes, I would say. I'm not someone that puts on weight very quickly or very easily, but also to be fair, I'm 23 and I would say that my metabolism is at its best right now. It is something that declines with age, so if I'm 40, for example, I will probably put on weight more quickly. Weight is not something that I'm too worried about because I am kind of fortunate enough that I don't put on weight too quickly. But I do try to be healthy in the sense that I eat healthily and I try not to overeat. I try not to over-snack, and I also try to work out as much as I can. That is something that I am still working on. I really try to work out at least twice a week. Sometimes I don't manage to do that, but if I don't work out, then I at least try to go for a walk for at least half an hour. But I just try to get some type of movement in. But my goal is not really to look a certain way, but rather to be healthy when I'm 80 so I can spend my time with my grandchildren outside, maybe doing some type of cool activity. I don't want to be the grandma that cannot walk properly and all I can do is sit at my chair and look at my grandchildren play. I want to be able to play with them. So that is kind of my motivation to stay healthy and stay fit. I also don't weigh myself very seldomly. I will weigh myself, but just because I feel like the number will really stress me out. So I try not to focus so much on numbers, but rather on how I feel overall. Then someone else asked, what part of Germany are you in? I'm in Heidelberg. Hi to you in Heidelberg. I am in Bavaria, in the northern part of Bavaria. I prefer not to say the city just for privacy's sake, and I don't live in a very big city, so I prefer to keep that private. But my German side of the family is originally from around Munich, so from the southern part of Bavaria. Someone else said, I've learned that you're half Taiwanese. Have you visited Taiwan or stayed there for quite some time maybe? I've been there twice and I'm loving everything. I truly don't know one single person that does not love Taiwan. Yes, I have been there. My Taiwanese family lives there. I have lived there as a child as well. I think from first grade to second or third grade, something like that. So yeah, I've lived there for 2 to 3 years, and I've been there other than living there as well to visit. But yeah, I absolutely love Taiwan. I'm not there too often, but every time I'm there, it feels nice. It feels wholesome, and it is somewhere that I am from. Then the last question is, can you share some of your childhood recollections? So I thought this question was really sweet and really funny, but I didn't really know what to share because I would say I had a very happy and fun childhood. I had a very privileged childhood, I would say. I lived in a bunch of different places when I was younger. I was born in Germany. I had moved to Singapore, then back to Germany, then to Taiwan, then back to Germany, and then to Shanghai. I lived a very, very large part of my childhood in Shanghai. And then I graduated from high school, and now I moved back to Germany again. So I've had a very adventurous and beautiful childhood, I would say, with a lot of stories, so I didn't know what to share. When I think about random childhood memories, something that comes to mind, which might be a random story, but you asked for it, is that when I was in kindergarten, this was when I lived in Germany, I was in this kindergarten that had two classes and they were named after animals. So I was in the mouse class and the other class was the bunny or rabbit class. And all I really remember from kindergarten is having playtime. I don't know if they taught us things. If they did, I don't remember, but I just remember the playtime. And I remember there were lots of different stations that you could play at. There was the outside kind of yard. Then there was a place where they had large Lego building blocks where I think mostly boys were like building houses and walls and things like that. I think my favorite play area was this dress-up area. They had kind of old big dresses and high heels that belonged to, I think, grandmas. The heels weren't super high or anything. And I remember there were three pairs of those high heels, and every time when it was playtime, I would try to rush to the dress-up area so that I could get my favorite pair of heels, because the other two heels had very thin heels and I wasn't able to walk in them, and the pair that I liked had very thick chunky heels, so I was able to walk in them more easily. But I remember one day I thought I'd try something new, I'd venture out and get out of my comfort zone, so I decided I would visit the other classroom, the bunny classroom. So I walked over there and I looked around. It was all a little intimidating because it was so new and I had never really taken the time to look at it. I decided to get out this puzzle and started to take it apart and try to piece it back together. And then the bell rang. That meant that recess or playtime was over. I was kind of struggling or thinking that, oh, I need to put this away now. But in order to tidy away or put away my puzzle, I had to piece it back together before I was able to put it away. But that was the difficult part. I didn't know how to piece this puzzle back together. And I remember the teacher or the adult coming over and telling me that I need to put this away now, playtime is over. And I was just so stressed and struggling with this puzzle that I didn't know how to put together. And because there was this time pressure, I was just even more stressed and just staring at this puzzle that I didn't know how to put together. And I think because of the stress and because I was so overwhelmed, I think I started crying. And the teacher got really annoyed at me, thinking that why is this child crying just because it cannot put together or a puzzle, or why isn't she even trying to put it together? But she kind of pushed me to the side and put the puzzle back together in like 2 seconds or so. It was probably a super easy puzzle. And she put it away and led me back to my classroom. But that was so traumatic that, for one, I remember it until now. And number two is I never ever ventured out into that other classroom again. I stayed in my classroom. I was so traumatized by that I never wanted to go back into that classroom. So yeah, that is my little random story. Hopefully you found that somewhat interesting. Maybe now you know a different side of me that I think very few people know. I think very, very few people know the story. I'm not even sure if my parents or my friends know the story, But yeah, now you guys know it. This is it for my Q&A. Hopefully this isn't too long. I feel like I've been talking for so long, and hopefully you guys got good answers to your questions. I had a lot of fun answering this. If you have any other questions or follow-up questions, then be sure to comment them down below. Maybe if there are enough questions in the comments, I will do another one of these. And if you like this, give it a thumbs up and also subscribe if you want to see more of me. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.